of Squirrel Nutkin. It was written by Beatrix Potter. This is a tale about a tail. Tail that belonged to a little squirrel and his name was Nutkin. He had a brother called Twinkleberry and a great many cousins. They lived in a wood at the edge of a lake. In the middle of the lake, there's an island covered with trees and nut bushes, and amongst those trees stands a hollow oak tree, which is the house of an owl, who is called Old Brown. One autumn, when the nuts were ripe and the leaves on the hazel bushes were golden and green, Nutkin and Twinkleberry and all the other little squirrels came out of the wood and down to the edge of the lake. They made little rafts out of twigs. They paddled away over the water to our island to gather nuts. Each squirrel had a little sack and a large oar and spread out its tail for a sail. They also took with them an offering of 3 fat mice as a present for Old Brown and put them upon his doorstep. Then Twinkleberry and the other squirrels each made a low bow and said politely, "Oh, Mr. Brown, will you favor us with permission to gather nuts upon your island?" But Nutkin was excessively impertinent in his manners. He popped up and down like a little red cherry, singing, "Little me, rot, tot, tot, a little wee man in a red, red coat, a staff in his hand and a stone in his throat. If you tell me this riddle, I'll give you a groat." Now this riddle is as old as the hills. Mr. Brown paid no attention whatever to Nutkin. He shut his eyes obstinately and went to sleep. The squirrels filled their little sacks with nuts and sailed away home in the evening. But next morning, they all came back again to our island and Twinkleberry. And the others put a fine fat mole and laid it on the stone in front of Old Brown's doorway and said, "Mr. Brown, will you favor us with your gracious permission to gather some more nuts?" But Nutkin, who had no respect, began to dance up and down, tickling Old Mr. Brown with a nettle and singing, "Old Mr. B, little me wee, hitty pitty within the wall, hitty pitty without the wall. If you touch hitty pitty will bite you." Mr. Brown woke up suddenly and carried the mole into his house. He shut the door in Nutkin's face. Presently, a little thread of blue smoke from a wood fire came up from the top of the tree, and Nutkin peeped through the keyhole and sang, "A house full, a hole full, and you cannot gather a bowl full." The squirrels seemed for nuts all over the island and filled in little sacks, but Nutkin gathered up apples yellow and scarlet and sat upon a beech stump, playing marbles and watching the door of Old Mr. Brown. On the third day, the squirrels got up very early and went fishing. They got 7 fat minnows as a present for Old Brown. They paddled over the lake and landed under a crooked chestnut tree on our island. Twinkleberry and 6 other squirrels each carried a fat minnow. But Nutkin, who had no nice manners, but no person at all, he ran in front singing, "The man in the wilderness said to me, 'How many strawberries grow in the sea?' I answered him as I thought, 'Good, as many red herrings as grow in the wood.'" But Old Mr. Brown took no interest in riddles, not even when the answer was provided for him. On the fourth day, the squirrels brought a present of 6 fat beetles, which was called plums and plum pudding for Old Brown. His beetle was locked up carefully in a dark leaf, fastened with a pine needle pin. But nothing sent as soon as ever. Old Mr. Bee, little Mill Lee, flower of England, fruit of Spain, met the dragon in a shower of rain, put in a bag tied round with a string. If you tell me this riddle, I'll give you a ring. Which was the ridiculous of nothing, because he had not got any ring to give Old Brown. The other squirrels hunted up and down the nut bushes, but nothing gathered Robin's pincushions off a briar bush and stuffed them full of pine needle pins. On the fifth day, the squirrels bought a present of wild honey. It is so sweet and sticky that they lick their fingers as they put it down upon the stone. They had stolen it out of a bumblebee's nest on the tippity top of the hill, but Nutkin skipped up and down singing, "Hum a bum buzz buzz, hum a bum buzz." As I went over Tipple Tide, I met the flock of bonny swine. Some yellow neck, some yellow back. They were the very bonniest swine that we went over Tipple Tide. Old Mr. Brown turned up his eyes in disgust at the impertinence of Nutkin, but he ate up the honey. The squirrels filled their little sacks with nuts, but Nutkin sat upon a big flat rock and played ninepins with a crab apple and green fruit cones. On the sixth day, which was Saturday, the squirrels came again for the last time. They bought a new laid egg in a little wash basket as a last parting present for Old Brown. But Nutkin ran in front, laughing and shouting, "Humpty Dumpty lies in the bag with a white counterpane around his neck. 40 duckies and 40 lights cannot put Humpty Dumpty to life." Now Old Mr. Brown took an interest in eggs. He opened one eye and shut it again. But still, he did not speak. Nutkin became more and more impertinent. "Old Mr. Bee, Old Mr. Bee, hackamore, on the king's kitchen door. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't drive hackamore off the king's kitchen door." Nutkin danced up and down like a sunbeam. But still, Old Brown said nothing at all. Nutkin began again. "Arthur O'Bower has broken his plan. He comes roaring up the land. The king of Scots with all his power cannot turn Arthur off the bower." Nutkin made a whirring sound to sound like the wind, and he took a running jump right into the head of Old Brown. Then all at once there was a fluttering and a scuffling and a loud squeak. The other squirrels scuttled away into the bushes. When they came back, very cautiously peeping on the tree, was Old Brown sitting on his doorstep, quite still with his eyes closed, as if nothing had happened. But Nutkin was in his waistcoat pocket. Old Brown carried Nutkin into his house and held him up by the tail, intending to skin him. But Nutkin pulled so very hard that his tail moved in two, and he dashed up the staircase and escaped out of the attic window. And to this day, if you meet Nutkin up a tree and ask him a riddle, he will throw sticks at you and stamp his feet and scold and shout, "Cock, cock, 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 cock." The end. And that was The Tale of Squirrel Nutkin by Beatrix Potter. Thanks for watching. Bye!